What's up, Peep Squad? Peep Squad is in the building, baby. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'll be greatly appreciated. Let's get down to the nitty gritty. Let's talk about Candy Burris and Tor Talker and also Jamal Bryant not paying their taxes. Like, what's going on? We know that Candy Burris is a multimillionaire and she can pay $15,000 with her eyes closed. What's going on in this situation? Does Candy Burris and Tor Talker have their hands in too many pots and too many kitchens where they're not focusing on the OLG restaurant, which Bravo is shooting a spinoff, and basically they're getting scores that are so low. It's just like, damn, how can we shoot a, you know, TV show with these scores? What's going on? It seems like Candy Burris and Tor Talker are falling behind when it comes to their restaurant business and establishments and making sure they pass the health inspection test. They are busy shooting movies, shooting TV shows, just doing everything else but focusing on the people that are working in their restaurant. Are they being set up? Do people not care that work for Tor Talker and Candy Burris, where they just let everything fall apart, especially when the health inspector come? They act like they got no clue and no sense what's supposed to be happening. I guess maybe the employees are putting Candy Burris and Tor Talker on blast by when the inspectors show up. You know, they show out and make sure that they do everything completely, utterly wrong. Doesn't Tor Talker's daughter need a job? You know, make her in charge of these restaurants. But in any event, reality TV star Candy Burris and allegedly refusing to pay her tax bill. Her and Tor Talker are refusing to pay their tax bill. Radar Online obtained court documents detailing the federal tax lien that the IRS has put against Candy Burris and Tor Talker. The company, Burris Tor Talker Restaurant Group, LLC, basically, they're saying, according to the documents, that the Real Housewives of Atlanta and her husband are refusing to pay $15,000, 800.52 cents owed, and their tax bill of 2020. And the IRS basically says if Tor Talker and Candy Burris do not pay their tax bill, they can basically seize their property and seize, you know, things that they have too as well if the bill continues to go unpaid. I was like, Lord have mercy, what is going on? So the IRS is out here threatening, you know, Tor Talker and Candy Burris that they're going to seize, you know, some of the things in the restaurant or their property altogether if this tax bill goes unpaid. I was like, Lord have mercy, what's going on? Candy, you got the money. You can afford to pay the bill. What's going on? What's happening? Where's the accountant? Where are the people that's supposed to work for you? Because you have an empire. And usually Candy Burris can turn sugar into shit. So why is she letting her restaurants fall apart? You know, maybe she's depending on Tor Talker to do his job, but he's too busy doing what he wants to do, and that's producing shows. And maybe, you know, being a nanny and the father to the kids. Like, what is happening? What is going on in this situation? So you guys let me know what you think about this. I was like, damn. But in any event, nobody wants to pay their effing taxes, because, you know, me as my taxes, I pay more than Bill Gates. And sometimes these tax bills be like, oh my God, you serious? I owe you guys that much? Like, for real? Nobody wants to pay them that much money because you barely making a profit. But I'm talking about myself. You know, Candy Burris is making a profit. But, you know, I'm not even in the same, you know, income or the tax bracket as Candy Burris, and I'd be having a problem. $15,000, I would have fainted and hit the floor. But she got the money. But in any event, I pay too much in taxes. But let's get down to her restaurants. Like, when it comes down to the old lady gang, baby, you know, they've been receiving C's and C's and B's and A's. But now you're about to shoot a spinoff, and your restaurant is doing bad out here in these streets. So it seems like the old lady gang Southern Eatery, for July 14, 2021, their score was a 75 and they received a C. And you guys want to shoot a spinoff in this situation? Like, what's going on? Like, what's happening? OMG, like, at least if they're shooting a spinoff, Candy Burris and Tor Talker and the rest of the aunties can see what's going on in the restaurant, because apparently they ain't paying attention to what's going on because they're receiving a C. I was like, Lord have mercy, Candy, what is happening? What is going on? And then let's talk about, you know, the other restaurant, Blaze Steak and Seafood. They received a C on May 28, 2021. a 77, which is a C. And then on May 19, 2021, they received a 55 grade, a U. Like, basically, it was like, you got to shut the shit down. So what's going on with Candy Burris and Tor Tucker? What are they doing out here in these streets? They better get everything and focus and make sure they have the right employees, the right chef, and the right workers working in their restaurant, because pretty soon somebody's going to go into that restaurant and claim food poisoning, claiming that they're sick, they lost wages, and they have to go to the emergency room, they have to take medication, you know, they have PTSD because of what happened to them at, you know, one of Candy Burris and Tortoka restaurant, and they will be doing it for the clout, and then they will probably become an internet sensation. So Candy Burris and Tortoka, they both know about the clout chasing, and it would be easy to target Candy and Tor Tucker about, you know, getting sick at their restaurant and what it costs for them to get sick and what happened, and describing their situation, get on TikTok, get on Instagram, get on YouTube, and basically be doing it for the clout, because Candy Burris and Tor Tucker are leaving the door open for anybody to get sick or something to happen to them while they are at Candy Burris and Tor Tucker eateries. You know what I mean? I mean, like, damn, the staff be, like, doing the most over there. They're basically handling food. They're handling raw oysters. And then they touch raw salmon. And then they proceed to ready-to-eat food with the same gloves on. And then want to feed people, too, as well. Cross-contamination. You know, the light fixtures ain't working in the place. They're not storing the food in the right temperatures and the right conditions. They're basically saying the salmon is being cooked because it's stored in the wrong conditions at point-blank period. Like, what's going on? And, like, you know, cross-contamination, you know, cleaning solutions all over the place, foreign, you know, liquids found in the restaurant. Like, y'all need to get it together, or somebody else is gonna get you together with a lawsuit. Like, baby, Candy Burris and Tor Tucker, what's going on? You guys are too busy. You need to hire some more help. There's a lot of people that are looking for jobs and looking to work for Candy Burris and Tor Tucker. So get to stepping, get to trucking, get to moving, and clean this shit up. But in any event, let's move on to the situation when it calls for Jamal Bryant. Jamal Bryant is out here in these streets too as well. He owes some taxes. This is Gisele Bryant's ex-husband, baby. He had been accused of owing $740,000 in back taxes. What are you doing out here in these streets, Jamal Bryant? I thought, you know, pastors didn't have to pay taxes. Like, what's going on? Like, you need a new accountant, because all the money that you should be getting should be coming in through the church, so you don't have to pay taxes. Man, this man owes almost nearly $800,000 in back taxes. I was like, Lord have mercy, what's going on? So according to the official records attained by Radar Online, the pastor reality TV store was hit with a federal lien by the Internal Revenue Service on March 19th. Basically, the documents claim that Jamal Bryant owed money. Like, damn, Gisele, you didn't know your ex-husband owed money out here in these streets? You know, you've been talking about Karen and her husband, Ray, and they owe so much money in taxes, and then Karen and Ray can't buy a house because they owe so much money in taxes. But Gisele, before you talk about somebody else's shit, you better make sure your shit with your ex-husband is clean too as well, because when you throw mess out there, you throw shit out there, it falls back on you. So now Jamal Bryant is out here owing all this money. So according to the documents, Jamal owes from 2008, 2010, 2011, 2012, 2014, 2015, 2016, 2018, and the debt is broken down like this. Jamal Bryant owes $300,000. Are you kidding me? I'm like, what is happening? Jamal, what are you doing out here in these streets? You owe too much money. Like, what is going on, Jamal? Like, what are you doing? Jamal owes $302,044 from 2008, and then he owes $99,427.57 in 2020. 10. And then he also owes $132,244.78 in 2011. And then in 2012, he owes $78,788.20. Like, shit, you was skipping. You was paying for that poo-poo. You was paying for that na-na. You was paying for that ill na-na that you told the tax man he can kiss your ass. And also, Jamal owes $28,039.41 in 2014. Damn, damn, damn. And then also $49,000 and $148 in 2016. And he owes $336,000.55 in 2018. The Internal Revenue Service got a problem. They want the 14 cents. They want 15 cents. They want it all. So therefore, he owes money out here in these streets. So maybe he's robbing Peter to pay Paul, but he better call on Jesus to help him with this situation. Or maybe he might avoid paying taxes forever and ever, ever. Gisele Bryant was accordingly married to Jamal Bryant from 2002 until 2009. So, baby, Gisele, you didn't know he wasn't paying his taxes. You didn't know your former husband owed some money. Are you part of this debt bill? Like, what's going on in this situation? You tried to shame Karen in the new season about not being able to buy a house, but girl, your man can't buy a house. Your ex-man can't buy a house. Your ex husband, your ex-boyfriend, your baby father, he owes a whole lot of money. You gonna help him with that tax bill, girl? See, this is why you cannot throw rocks when you live in a glass mother effing house. Candy, get it together. We expect more from you.